Obviously, that much travel, the kinds of things you do to train people, you've got supplies, you've got material that you need just to allow them to exist. How do you raise the resources to do that?
I pray for them. And if someone asks us, do you have needs? Like the Millers. They're big supporters. In fact, almost all our armored vehicles they paid for the battle in Iraq.
Even though all those vehicles got blown up.
Yeah, well, some of them did. And the two Humvees gone, but they've been replaced and they saved our lives.
So I remember one day I was on the phone with Dave and he had just gone over to Kurdistan. I said, Dave, what do you need? I was sitting in the Home Depot parking lot on my lunch break. And he said something about, hey, you know, we could use a vehicle, but pray about it because, you know, we don't want to spend money on it because it could possibly be blown up and we don't want to dump all kinds of money in something that's just going to get destroyed. And I said, man, that's fine, not a problem, right? How much you need? And to make sure that it's clear that it wasn't just us, that some of our friends, I came to them and said, hey, here's my friend. He's doing such great work in Mosul. He's rescuing people who are being shot at. You want in on this or not? And so they helped contribute to that too. So it certainly wasn't just us. And he was able to get that vehicle. And then it turned out that they used it so much that they had more need for something like that. And I said, cool, but do you need anything armored?
I don't need armored vehicles. Never use them in Burma. What would we do with them? Pray about it. So we prayed and I felt, yeah, if you want to be in the front line in a mechanized war, you need armor. You're gonna be dead in a smoldering vehicle. So they bought our whole fleet of vehicles.
A couple snipers over there opened up on us. Just missed us back here on the side all around here. And then the Iraqi army fired back and suppressed them. Thank God again for one armored vehicle. The other ambulance didn't, but nothing hit it. Thank you, Jesus.
You see stuff like this on the news all the time of what's going on in the Middle East and Iraq, and you feel really powerless. You look at it and you're like, I'm not there. I can't do anything. But we have these friends that are there, and it's a way of contributing the way that we have.
We don't fundraise in the classical sense of please give us money, because nothing wrong with that at all. But I don't trust myself, and I don't want to get something I'm not supposed to have. And maybe that will change, but so far what we try to do is, Lord, what do we need? Let's listen to you, and then please give us these things. And then if someone asks, we tell them. We need ambulance, we need medical supplies, we need food, we need playgrounds, whatever it is. That's how we've done it. And people have donated, individuals, churches, some organizations. And so we never know month by month what's gonna happen.
God has blessed us with the ability to give, right? So not everyone's in that position, but everybody can give something. And God doesn't say it's the amount that you give, it's your heart's attitude. So every day when I go to work, I feel like I'm part of the team.
Just being involved in their lives has been, it's been life-changing for us in a lot of different ways. Being a family, raising kids in America, you have blinders on with your own culture and the way everybody seems to be doing things, all the sports, go to Disney World, everybody save for college. And the Eubanks just give you a different picture of what life can look like that kind of shocks you out of the rut that you're living in and gives you another picture of, hey, this is another way we could lead our family. This is another way we can think about life and what's important and what's not important.
They put their faith on the line every day, and you see it, their faith played out in such tangible ways. And I think a lot about when Jesus says that you need to lose your life to find it. And these guys, they're not afraid to lose their lives. And you can see that they live such abundant lives because of it.